95 FM
and 810 medium wave.
BBC Radio Scotland. The news for Shetland with Jane Moncrief. Good afternoon. A US import ban on salmon from fish farms that shoot seals will go ahead, despite an attempt by the Scottish Government to avoid it. Daniel Lawson reports.
Emails have emerged showing officials attempted to seek an exemption of the US rules banning imports of fish from farms which kill marine animals, including seals. Fish farms here are licensed to kill the animals to prevent them from attacking and eating salmon in farm cages. The US is the world's largest importer of seafood, buying around $20 billion worth of product every year, including Scottish salmon worth £193 million last year. The campaign group Salmon Watch Scotland obtained the emails under Freedom of Information laws. In them, officials from Marine Scotland said that the rules in this country do not allow the reckless shooting of seals, but the US National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration have listed Scotland's industry as being officially covered by the ban. It's thought that around 150 fish farms from across the country are likely to be affected.
The owner of a local waste management facility has admitted accepting more fish farm waste than permitted by the Scottish Environment Protection Agency. Total Waste Management says it breached CEPA's waste limit regulations at Vatsar Quarry because of higher than usual mortality rates from Shetland salmon farms. The firm was responding after the BBC received Freedom of Information requests made to CEPA by an anti-salmon farming campaigner. Ewan Murray reports.
In the last week of October 2017, CEPA received three incident notifications about the Vatsar Quarry waste facility. These included complaints from the public about a bad smell and a higher than usual number of birds around the site near Laxfirth. The company also reported itself to CEPA during this time for storing more fish waste than its licence allows, saying that this was due to an unforeseen disease outbreak causing higher than usual mortality rates at local salmon farms. The firm also reported an accidental spillage of processed salmon waste from the back of a trailer, but it said that this was an isolated incident dealt with in accordance with environmental regulations. TWMA has implemented an odour management plan, but it denies that the smell, birds and spillage were in any way linked to it breaching waste limits. CEPA says that while there had been no environmental impact from these incidents, it's now working with TWMA to review its licence to make sure that it better reflects its operations.
The Sumbra Airport consultant